In this video, we shall discuss how to calculate the value of repossessed stock when the buyer, that is the hire purchaser, default in payment, and in consequence of that default, the seller is taking only the part of the goods that he has sold. That is, the buyer did not make a payment, failed to pay an installment amount, so the buyer is taking back the goods. Not all the goods, only a part of the goods that he has sold. So let's move on to the video. This is the question that I have taken. Balaji and Co. purchased from the vendor two machines of ₹10,500 each on hire purchase system. The payment was to be made 6,000 down and the remainder in three equal installment of ₹5,000 each, together with interest at 5% per annum. Balaji and Co. writes off depreciation at 10% per annum on written down value. They could not pay their second installment. After negotiation, it was agreed that vendors would leave one plant with the purchaser, adjusting the other against amount due. Vendor charged 20% depreciation. Show accounts in the books of both the parties. Okay. In this question, the purchaser could not pay their second installment. So there is default by the buyer. The buyer did not make a payment. So what happened? After negotiation, it was agreed that vendor would leave one plant with the purchaser. So the vendor is leaving one plant with the hire purchaser and he is taking only one plant. Totally two machines were sold. One is left with the buyer, the other is taken by the seller. So there is default in this problem, and in consequence of the default, the seller is taking partial repossession, a part of the goods. One plant is taken by the seller, one is left with the buyer. So there is default and there is partial repossession. Okay, before moving on to calculating a value of repossessed stock, we will calculate interest. For calculating interest, let us look into the question for information that is given. See, the Balaji and Co. purchased from vendor two machines of ₹10,500 each. So cash price is given. The payment was to be made 6,000 down. Down payment is there. Three equal installments of 5,000 each, together with interest at 5% per annum. So in this problem, cash price is given, down payment is given, rate of interest is given, but interest installment amount is not given. Why I am telling that? This 5,000 rupees is three equal installment of 5,000 each, together with interest. Normally, the installment amount will include interest. But here, 5,000 rupees is given, but this 5,000 rupees does not include interest. That is what is given, together with interest. So this is not the installment amount. This is only the cash price component of the installment amount. So how are we going to calculate? So I have given this table here, particulars column, total cash price, installment, interest, cash price paid. Okay, I have started the answer with the cash price column. Okay, the cash price of the asset is 10,500, but the buyer is purchasing two machines of ₹10,500 each. So he is buying two machines. The cost of one machine is 10,500. So we are calculating how much for two machines. 10,500 into 2, 21,000 is the cash price for two machines. Okay. The first payment that is made is the down payment. The down payment that is given in the question is 6,000 rupees. So I am writing 6,000 in the second column. This 6,000 is also a part of the installment. Down payment is a part of the installment, but we will not calculate interest for down payment because down payment is paid immediately. Only for delayed payment we will calculate interest. So there is no interest. The total amount will come in the cash price column. Then 21,000 minus 6,000. 21,000 was outstanding, out of which 6,000 down payment was paid. So the balance outstanding amount is 15,000 rupees. Then the next payment is the first installment amount. The first installment amount is not given in the question. Only cash price is given. 5,000 is paid together with interest. So without interest, 5,000 is the cash price. So I am writing 5,000. You all know in this column, we will write only the cash price. So 5,000, I am writing it in the second column and also in the cash price column I am writing 5000. Then we are calculating interest. Interest will be calculated on the outstanding balance. So the outstanding balance is 15000. On 15000, 5%, the amount of interest is 750. So usually what we will do, installment amount minus interest we will calculate. But here we don't know installment amount, but we know what is the cash price and we know what is the interest. So this cash price is 5000 plus interest will give you installment. Okay, usually installment minus interest we will calculate, but here installment amount is not given. So cash price plus interest will give you installment amount. So now 15,000 was due, out of which 5,000 we paid in the first installment. So the balance outstanding amount is 10,000 rupees. Now we are calculating for the second installment. Second installment amount, again we don't know the installment amount, but we know the cash price. So we are writing the 5,000 rupees here and in the cash price column also. Then we are calculating interest on the outstanding balance. The interest is 500 rupees. Then we have to calculate installment amount. Cash price plus interest will give you this installment amount. So now the outstanding balance is 5000. We are calculating for the last installment. Again, we know only the cash price. So we are writing it in the second column and in the last column. Calculate interest on the outstanding balance. You will get interest. So installment, cash price plus interest will give you installment amount. Okay, so in detail I have explained how to calculate interest in another video. The link I have given it in the description box, so do watch that video for a better understanding. Here I have just quickly gone through the interest calculation. Okay, now let us see how to calculate the value of repossessed stock and the value of asset left with the buyer. That is, I already explained you that two machines are sold. The buyer defaulted in the second payment. So one plant is left with the buyer and one plant is taken with the seller. So how are we going to calculate the value of asset left with the buyer and the value of asset taken by the seller? That calculation is very simple. We are going to calculate depreciation. Only depreciation we are going to calculate. See, first is calculation of value of machinery left with the buyer. Buyer means higher purchaser. Okay. Okay. So how much asset is left with the buyer? One machinery, isn't it? Two machines were sold, out of which one is left with the buyer. So cost of one machinery we are taking. The cost of one machinery is 10,500. And what is the rate of depreciation that is charged by the buyer? Since we are calculating the value of asset left with the buyer, you have to calculate the depreciation charged by the buyer. See, in the question, Balaji and Co. writes off depreciation at 10% per annum. Balaji and Co. is the purchaser. At what value they charge depreciation? They charge depreciation at 10% on written down value. So we are charging depreciation on written down value for the first year. 10,500 into 10%, 1050 is the depreciation for the first year. From 10,500, deduct first year depreciation. The written down value in the second year is 9,450. Okay, now we are charging depreciation for the second year. Since it is on written down value, we are calculating it on 9,450. Rate of depreciation is 10%, so the amount of depreciation will be 945. Okay, deducted from the 9450, the answer that you get is value of asset left with the buyer. Okay, now you can ask me why I have calculated for 2 years. Because the buyer, look into the question, the buyer did not pay the second installment. That means he paid the first installment. So we are calculating depreciation for the first installment. Then second year. Second year is the default year. So for the but the asset is used by the buyer in the second year also. In the year of default also, he used the asset and only at the end of the year he was not able to make the payment. So in the second year, the buyer was using the asset. So we are charging depreciation for the second year also. So you have to charge depreciation till the year of default. For the year of default also you will charge depreciation, and after that whatever balance you are getting, that is the value of asset taken over. You understood? We will calculate depreciation for the value of asset left with the buyer. For how many years you have to calculate depreciation? Till the year of default. For how many years he has made payment, and for the year of default also you will calculate depreciation. Whatever balance amount you get after charging depreciation till the year of default, that will be the value of machine left with the buyer. Okay, now we have to calculate value of machinery repossessed by the higher vendor. What is the value of asset taken by the seller? Okay, this again we are going to charge depreciation. How many assets the seller is taking back? The seller is taking back one machinery. So the cost of one machinery is 10,500. And when you are charging depreciation, now we are charging depreciation in the seller's book, in the higher vendor book. So you have to take the rate of depreciation that is followed by the seller. See, the vendor charged 20% depreciation. So we are taking the rate of depreciation charged by the seller. So 10,500 into 20% 2,100 is the amount of depreciation. Deducted, the written down value is 8,400. For the second year also we are charging depreciation. 8,400 into 20% 1,680 is the amount. Deducted, the answer that you get is the value of asset taken by the seller, or value of repossessed stock. Again, why we are calculating depreciation for 2 years? Because the buyer paid first installment, he failed to pay the second installment. So till the year of default, we will calculate depreciation, and the balance amount will be the value of repossessed stock. Hope you understood this. Okay, now before moving on to this calculation, what I have given down is value of machinery left with the buyer, value of machinery taken back by the seller. This we have calculated in the previous calculation. I have just brought down the answers here. Now let us see how to record this in the ledger. First, I have started with the ledger accounts in the books of the higher purchaser. In this problem, the name of the higher purchaser is Balaji & Co. So ledger accounts in the books of Balaji & Co. We are writing higher vendor's account. I have already told you how to work out ledger accounts. If you did not watch that video, I have given the link in the description box. Do watch that video. Okay, in the first year, in the higher vendor's book, in the first year, we will have 4 transactions. One is for purchasing the asset, down payment, interest will become due, installment will become paid. Installment will be paid. So 4 transactions that we have to record. 2 in the debit side, 2 in the credit side. In the credit side, we will record purchase of machinery. The asset will be purchased, so that we will record. We will write the cost price of the asset. Then down payment will become due. So 2 cash account, the down payment amount is 6,000 rupees. So we are writing 6,000 in the amount column. Then interest will become due. We have calculated in the previous calculation, the first installment interest amount is 750. Then we will pay the first installment amount. The first installment amount, again we calculated in the previous calculation, it is 5,750. That's all. We will tally the account, find the balancing figure and bring down the balancing figure. So first year as it is, first year we will have 4 entries, 2 on the debit side, 2 on the credit side. In the debit side, 2 cash down payment, 2 cash first installment amount. In the credit side, buy machinery, cost price of the machinery, buy interest, first installment interest amount. That's all. Tally the account, find the balancing figure, bring down the balancing figure to the next year. Okay. When did the default is made by the buyer? See, the buyer could not pay their second installment. So second year is the year of default. Now we are working out ledger accounts in the second year. We have brought down the balance to the second year. This is the year of default. In the year of default, you will give interest due entry, but payment entry we will not give. why payment was not made. So interest will become due, but payment is not made. So I am writing due entry, interest due by interest account. Second installment, interest amount, I am writing in the amount column. Okay, now what should we do? After doing this, what should we do? We should record the value of machinery taken away by the hire vendor. The value of machinery that is taken away by the hire vendor is 6720. That we are transferring to machinery account. 6720 we are transferring to machinery account. How did we get the 6720? It is from our previous calculation. Value of machinery taken away or value of repossessed stock, that we are transferring to machinery account. Then tally your account. Whatever is the balancing figure, you will carry down the balancing figure. See, this is the balancing figure. We are carrying down the balancing figure. Okay, so in the year of default, we will give interest due entry, but we will not give payment entry. Instead, we will give transfer the value of repossessed stock to the asset account. This is the asset. In this problem, machinery is the asset. So we are transferring the value of repossessed stock to the asset account. Tally the account, find the balancing figure. That's all. Next, you will have to prepare asset account. In this problem, the asset is machinery. So we are preparing machinery account. In the asset account, first year you will have two entries. One is for purchasing the asset, second is for charging depreciation. So for purchasing the asset, to hire vendor account, write the cash price amount in the amount column. At the end of the accounting year, we are charging depreciation. Depreciation account 2100. When you are charging depreciation, you have to calculate, you have to take the rate of depreciation followed by the hire purchaser, that is the buyer, because we are working out ledger accounts in the books of the buyer. So you will take this 10% rate of depreciation. So this 21,000 into 10 by 100 will give you 2,100. Calculate the balancing figure, bring down the balancing figure to the next year. Next year is the second year. It is the year of default. So on the year of default, what you will do? You have to charge depreciation entry because the asset is being used for the year of default also. For the whole year, the asset is used. So depreciation we will charge. So 18,900 into 10%, 1,890 is the depreciation. After charging depreciation, see, we have transferred one amount to machinery account. This one. We have transferred one amount to machinery account. So we are bringing down that by higher vendor account 6,720. Again, how did we get that 6,720? It is from our calculation, from our depreciation calculation. That we have transferred to first higher vendor account, and now from higher vendor account, we are transferring to machinery account also. Okay, after recording this value, you have to record the value of machinery left with the buyer. This will be your balance carried down. Balance carried down in the machinery account is not the balancing figure. It is the value of machinery left with the buyer. Did you understand? 8,505. This amount I have taken from this calculation. Balance carried down. It is not a balancing figure. It is the value of machinery left with the buyer. After recording this, tally your account. Whatever balancing figure you get, you may get it in the debit side or you may get it in the credit side. Transfer it to P&L account. In this problem, I am getting it in the credit side, which means loss. My debit balance is more, so this is a loss. This loss I am transferring to the profit and loss account. So in case of repossession, giving ledger account is very simple. Till the year of default, you give ledger accounts. In the year of default, you transfer the value of repossessed stock to the hire vendor account. Then value of asset left with the buyer, that will be your balance carried down. Tally your account, whatever balancing figure, transfer to P&L account. Let's see how to prepare ledger accounts in the books of hire vendor. So now we are preparing ledger accounts in the books of hire vendor. Hire vendor is the seller. So we have to think in the point of view of the seller. The first year, asset is sold, down payment is received, interest will become due, installment amount will be received. These are the four entries in the first year. So that's the four entry I have recorded, two in the debit, two in the credit. In the debit side, higher sales, we are recording cash price of the asset, two interest, first installment interest amount. By cash, down payment, 6000 rupees is the down payment. By cash, first installment interest amount. Tally your account, calculate the balancing figure. Bring down the balancing figure to the next year. Second year is the year of default. For the year of default, interest will become receivable, but payment is not received. So we cannot give cash received entry. We can give only interest due entry. So interest due entry, we have given two interest account. 500 is the interest for the second installment, but we did not receive cash, so we cannot give cash entry. Okay, now what should we do? We have already calculated the value of asset repossessed, value of asset taken away by the seller, 6720. Record that 6720, transfer it to repossessed stock account. 6720 is the value of asset taken back by the seller. That amount will be transferred to repossessed stock account. Tally your account, calculate the balancing figure, and that balancing figure will be carried down. Yes, I hope you understood this very simple calculation only. So I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.